Okay, in this video, we'll go ahead and explain some basic data types in Python. I will use my green color this time, and I will just focus on these two, numbers and string. These are also data types. We'll talk about them when we need to. As you know, we don't go into all the concepts in one go. We train or learn as we need to. We discover things we need to learn and then we study about them, right? One of the things I want all of you to remember is to look at the video which I posted earlier called Variables. It's a video around variables. Highly recommended. You have to watch that video, the video around variables before we go into this. This is a little more, a little different because once you understand that, you will easily understand this. So you can have variables and variables can have different types. Like I said, I'll just focus on these two. Numbers, we'll start with numbers, okay? And then we talk about strings, string. And these are, like I said, basic data types in Python. So numbers, there are two types of numbers within Python. Actually, there are much more than two types, but the ones which I care about for now is the int type and the float type. So FLOAT. Now, the int type, funny names, huh? Float and int. But the int type is a whole number. So it could be, 1, 2, 3. These are examples of an int type. You can have negative integers too, -1, -10, and all that. But 1 to 3 typically used, especially in data analysis. You deal with a lot of these numbers and also floats. Floats are numbers with a decimal in it. So 1.01, 0.05. 1, 2, 3, 4.50. Let's say that's a salary. That's how much somebody earns, 50 cents, or 1,234.50. I think you get the idea now. So two types we will be focused on: int, which are kind of these kind of numbers, pretty much whole numbers, and float, which have decimals in them. Okay. The second one, which I want you to pay attention to, is string. It's really text information. Text type information. So example would be good example would be my somebody's name. Let's say Alice, or typically in Python it has quotes around it, so it'll be Alice. You could have the name or type of an animal. Let's say dog, but quotes, right? So textual information, that's what a string is. So remember, a string is textual information. And let me spend some time on strings in the example I have here, already written out for you folks. So I have a string here. I'm in my Jupyter environment, and I have a string, and I put hello world there, right? So hello world with an exclamation mark in quotes. Now, when I print the string, I get hello world, okay? It prints the complete string. If I print the first character, I get H. So if you put this thing in square brackets, that's the first character, and the string starts from the zeroth character onwards. I think you're seeing a pattern with the zero character, right? So zero string first character prints the first character of the string, and then 2:5 it tells me to print from the second character onwards. So let's say the second character 0, 1, 2. So it starts with L till the fifth character. So 2, 3, 4 till the fifth character. So it stops there. So three characters, right? So it is 2 to 4, not including the last one. Okay? So 2, 3, 4. So you get LLO. LLO. That's what you get. So pretty interesting concept, the string. You can do all this magic within the string. You can take different elements or different characters from this text and start printing them out. Now look at this one. This is a concept which has to be learned, especially in data science. You want to print you want to know whether this world, this text world, exists inside the string. Okay? In this string. Str, right? World inside the string, there is that, you know, there are these characters called world, this word called word, world, and it is true. So it prints out a boolean this time. A boolean is a new type, which I haven't introduced in my previous slide, but I just wanted you to be familiar with it. It's either true or false. So let's say I say print, let's say, is Alice, the word Alice in my string? Is Alice ever present in this text data? And the answer is no. But the system will come back, the computer will come back with the word false. A boolean always has only two values, a true or false. Let's see what it's going to come back with. I'll click on this cell. I'll just click on run. I got false. So that's how this works. So two concepts, a boolean. I printed a boolean because I'm saying, does this exist in the string? Other thing is this command called in. See, so string you can say some text with an n. I'll use different variations of it, different functions of string later, but I want you to understand this concept of a substring within a string, a subtext within a text, right? So substring within a text or substring within this string. And the answer came back as false. Now, this is pretty straightforward. It's the most basic of operations, and you already know it. I know you know it. But you're just adding 1 plus 20 and you get 21. 1 divided by 20, you get a float, a fraction back, right? 1 divided by 20 is actually 0.05. So, you know, 1 divided 20 times will give you 0.05. So if you add 0.05 20 times, you should get 20. You will get 20. Okay, now let's go into the next example of float. So 0.05 plus 0.05 should give you what? 0.1. I will take 0.1, but I took 0.1 and assigned that to this variable. You remember variables, right? String is a variable. STR is a string variable. This is a float type variable. Remember, data types. String is a, STR is a string type, and a float is a float type. I get this, and what I do again is after that, after I get 0.1, it's stored here in a float, if you remember the box concept in variables, which I have in that video, I have also posted below, that value within a float is further added to 1. So 0.1 plus 1 gets you 1.1. Again, I have the video at the bottom in case you're looking for the variable video, but these are the types which I want you to be familiar with. Just a quick summary. STR of string type, you can store string, you can run all these interesting substring functions of a string, and you can use all these, this one here, which is I can ask, hey, does this text or this string contain within the string? And the answer is false. I can run numerical operators, I can do fractions, I can run operations with a float. And that's it for now. Thank you.